I avoided certain death by grabbing the ledge at the last moment. I would have survived anyway because fall damage hasn't been implemented yet, but it will still be possible to cheat this way in the final version of the game. It's unrealistic, but I'm not too worried about it as long as it's fun, and I can imagine speedrunners taking advantage of this too. Speaking of speedrunning, instead of running around an object or climbing over it, sometimes crouch jumping will be much faster. I even added a small speed boost. Now it's actually faster to crouch jump than sprint, and I don't like that, because due to the competitive nature of speedrunning, this would be abused to hell and back. So I decided to reduce players' velocity by the same amount upon landing. Another cool feature is wall jumping, especially when combined with crouch jumping. It looks something like this from a third-person perspective and can help you reach high areas. This isn't a speedrun game per se, so what's with the emphasis on speedrunning? Well, initially I wanted to make a game where you run and jump a lot like a 3D platformer, but it got boring really quickly, so I decided to make an FPS game instead and kept all the movement logic. Clunky, slow, and unresponsive movement can ruin an action game, which is why I spent a lot of time refining player controls. You can start sprinting while crouched without pressing the crouch button again. The same goes for crawling. It's nothing fancy, but it makes the movement so much smoother. The logic is handled in this little macro. Okay, I made this a long time ago and I can't sleep at night knowing how terrible the code is, but I've decided to leave it as is because it works and it works very well. I'd lose too much time fixing something that isn't broken. It doesn't bother me that much, to be honest. At least the climbing code is much better.